So hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. My name is Leech, and we're playing a new game today, Bohemian Killing. It's like a detective action, not action really. It's like a detective simulator adventure game by the Moonwalls. They decided to give me a lovely key off Keymailer, and I thought, you know what? I might as well play something a bit different, something that I haven't done in a long time. You know, we've played a lot of detective stuff with Batman and, you know, a bit on all of the other games we kind of do, very detective-ish kind of games. We're going to be like the Sherlock of, I think this is set in Paris in 1900s or something. I'm not too sure. I didn't do a lot of background on this game. I just thought I might as well just download it, dive in, and see what this game is about. I can't really move my mouse. I'm using actually the controller, which is quite cool. So we're going to play the game right here, right now. Got a new game. This game adapts the choices you make. Each lie can change the verdict for better or for worse. Oh my god. Oh shit, Paris. 17th of... Is that October? 1894. Remember that during your testimony, you are not creating history. You are lying about what has already happened. In Bohemian Killing, there are hundreds of possibilities you can frame other people. Lie, manipulate evidence and witness, plead guilty, or even act insane. Holy shit. This looks fucking good.
She should be here by now.
Oh my god. Oh, whoa. Can I move? Oh shit, I can. Oh! Whoa! Open the door. It's locked. I can check the time? What time is it in this century? Yeah. What is the time? Oh! So oh! That's so cool. What time is that? Bitch! Give me my clock out. I'm gonna whack a bitch. Okay, it's 11:15. What does that say on the side? I can't read that. Oh my god. Extra draw your dagger? I don't want to kill people. Oh, sweet. Can I open this door? Bitch, let me in. Okay, the control's a little sensitive for my liking. What is this? Book. Read a book? 15 minutes? Sure, buddy. Let's read a book. Let's, like, waste time. In-game time runs like in real life, and it is important to arrange a reliable testimony. Oh, okay, I see. This game is made by a real-life lawyer, if you believe it or not. Okay, I can't open that door. Okay, we're opening this door. Enter the room. Hello? Okay, hint. You can skip dialogues by holding E, but I'm on the controller. During a testimony, it will skip a single dialogue line. During cutscenes in the courtroom, it will skip an entire scene and begin your next testimony. Shit, am I a detective? Or am I a murderer? That's a nice looking crotch you got there, boy. Whoa! What the fuck is this? Oh my god! Oh no! Oh, we're a murderer. Oh. Nighty night, bitch. I thought we were a detective. Do I have to kill her? Oh, this is hilarious. The Moonwalls present a game by Marcian Macaque, starring Stephanie Connor-Card. Pew, pew, pew. Pigeons fly. Bohemian Killing. So that's the murder that happened. Excuse me, Judge? I'm trying to speak here, man.
Mr. Eaton.
Mr. Eaton.
Okay. Shit, did I miss that? Fuck. You can skip... Yeah, I just realized I skipped the judge saying my...
Mr. Eaton, I'm talking to you.
Oh. Okay. Oh,
I'm
shit.
I'm sorry, Monsieur le Président. I was thinking. Do you understand the...
Oh, we're in a chair.
Sorry, but I have to ask the prosecutor to repeat... Monsieur Eaton,
Mr.
Do you
Eaton.
Consider it to be a joke?
Yes.
You're charged with a serious crime. Please
oh, shit.
Stay focused.
Don't tell Mr. me to stay Eaton, focused. Wait.
As I said, Fred Eaton of Marie,
I love it.
Marie Capet,
I love the soundtrack too. It's so like, oh, it reminds me of Sherlock Holmes.
That day, Alfred Eaton was at the theatrical premiere of Prométhée, Vol du Feu.
Food, food, food. I love it.
As it is apparent from the testimony of witnesses, the accused left at about 8.30 p.m. before the end of the banquet.
Oh, very fancy. Banquet.
At about 9.25 p.m., he rented a room in his name at the Caucasus Hotel, which is adjacent to the building in which he lives. It was in that room that approximately at 11.16 p.m., Marie Capet was murdered.
Marie Carpet was murdered.
Next, the accused returned to his house.
Okay, what a dirty bastard.
At 5 p.m., he entered his apartment in the company of Marie Capet, or let her in.
Okay.
It results from the fingerprint analysis. It did not show the victim's fingerprints on the outer side of the door. Only
since when is a doorknob like right in the middle of a freaking thing?
Alfred Newton, by means of deception,
is that the thing over there?
Threats, led the victim.
Pictures are so bad. Don't you have HD quality pictures?
On the first floor of his apartment. The police report did not indicate any signs of struggle or resistance.
No resistance. She just took it like a man. She just wanted to die.
The prototype of a torture machine of his construction, which was in the room along with medical tools and manuals of torture.
Oh my God. What a creep.
When Marie Capet realized what the accused intended to do, she...
How do you know she just realized this shit, man?
...hit the accused on the head, which caused a real threat to his life and, according to doctors, may have caused unconsciousness. The fingerprints of Marie Capet's left hand were found on the rod, as well as Alfred Eaton's traces of blood.
Okay.
Traces of blood were also found on the floor of that room.
Got to take in all the information, guys. All the information. Freaking detective mode at the moment.
As confirmed by medical examination. Seizing the opportunity, Marie Capet fled.
Oh, she survived! Whoa!
Stressed and in a hurry.
No wonder she's got all this shit on us. Or on that person, whatever.
Secured on the inside of the door of the apartment of the accused. Then,
the
Marie Capet
so
ran into
can
a
hear,
nearby
like, the,
hotel.
The, what is it called? The thing that you push
it
in the nail?
It was the same hotel in which the accused rented a room. As it appears from the testimony of the clerk, Marie Capet was extremely stressed, repeating the word.
Oh shit, she almost got murdered. You crazy? I'm totally fine trying to be murdered,
help.
You know.
When the clerk went to get some water to calm Marie Capet, she disappeared.
I think she needs more than just water. She needs
the
like
next
vodka
day,
or some shit.
On the 18th of October, about 8:32 a.m.,
oh, fuck.
A maid found her body in a room rented by Alfred Eaton. It was covered with numerous fingerprints of
Am
the victim
good?
And of the accused, and had traces of the victim's
traces.
The immediate cause of death was a severe blow to the abdomen in the liver area, with a blade of about 40
centimeters
length.
So that was us, or were we playing the guy?
The murder weapon constructed by the accused was secured.
That's a cool ass freaking
in his
weapon.
Apartment. Marie Capet's unwashed blood stains.
You've got a lot of massive photos just like appearing
well
out of nowhere, man. That's fucking amazing for the century.
The accused is also charged by the testimony of one of
testimony?
The neighbors.
I love the accents in this. It's very like what you'd expect as well.
In which
I like
they
it.
They both lived at about 11:30 p.m.
11:30 p.m.
The witness testified that the clothing of the accused was stained with blood.
Zakir!
Unfortunately, the said clothes were not found.
What?
At the time of committing the alleged crime, the accused was saved.
Wait, am I in jail?
Which means he acted
Is this
consciously.
Me? Oh, I am in jail. Shit.
Crimes,
I thought I was a witness or something.
To life
I'm not good at this game. God, it's going to be fun.
As the accused finally understood the indictment. Oui, Monsieur le Président.
I'm innocent.
Plead guilty.
Innocent.
The charges against him.
Innocent.
Non, Monsieur le Président. Does the accused want to provide explanation?
I want to explain my situation.
Oui,
I'm going to do flamage.
Could I ask you for some conversation time with my client?
Yes.
Of course.
Whoa, look at this shit.
I just wish it would not take too much time. We've already wasted too much of it.
My life is at stake.
You can look through evidence at any moment. It is available by pressing tab. I will show the defense evidence to the court at the time of your uncovering during the testimony. It might surprise the prosecutor. If necessary, you can recall the string of events according to the prosecution by pressing the Q key. Will you need my help during testimony?
Yes, I will need your help.
I will give you my advice and remind you of important facts and events.
Ooh. Shakyo.
Yes.
We are ready, Monsieur le Président.
Then let's get started.
Monsieur President. Come on, my attorney. I am an innocent man. I was there, but I did not kill. I killed her, but I didn't. You must believe me. Jesus, well, it was right next to my ear.
Le Feu. In which I am the lead designer. Starting at 7 p.m., I was at the premiere at the Opéra Garnier.
Jesus, control is very.
8:30 p.m.
It's quite sensitive. I think it changed it, but I can't be bothered.
I did not want to attend the dull banquet, and instead, I preferred to work. I said goodbye to Hugo Argent, president of Le Feu.
Le Feu?
And I drove home.
And I drove home.
I got there at about 9 p.m.
9 p.m. Oh, shit. Remember that your testimony, you are not creating history, you're a lion. Okay, I'm freaking gonna lie the living shit out of this place.
For a moment, I admired the charming streets of
Oh, god damn it. Okay, let's go.
I decided to go for an evening walk. For a moment, I admired the charming streets of Montmartre.
Oh, shit. So it's kind of like you walk around and it gives you like a story, yeah?
Then I read cultural
And then I took a massive shit. Mort Ox.
Slogans inciting to the new revolution written on the walls by the rabble.
Oh, what's this fat guy? What's that fat guy doing with that babe? Why is this caveman lighting his sausage?
Had taken place a few hours before, and that's where I spent the evening.
Is this a bird? Prometheus Voltu Fair, Opera Canale. Jesus.
I noticed an advertisement for a play sponsored.
Yeah, I noticed like there's this weird caveman trying to light his sausage on fire. And this freaking massive eagle is just like trying to look at my ding dong. Weird son of a bitch. Okay, what's this? Hello? Oh, we can open the gate. Open the gate.
I opened the gate.
Wait, is this her house? I don't want to go in there yet. I want to go here.
For a moment, I admired the charms of Montmartre.
So we can't, like... Let's admire the newspaper. 15 minutes? Okay, let's add 15 minutes on.
I read cultural announcements.
An important event is approaching, right, Bumper, to get acquainted with it. Is this an important guy? Hello?
I entered the Café de Paris cafeteria. I wanted to drink some good wine and eat a piece of cheese.
As you do, you know, you just want to eat a piece of cheese and some wine.
Tried to throw me out, screaming that there was no room for gypsy thieves.
What?
Beat me and threw me into the street. I was all covered in blood.
Did you report this fact to police officers?
Who the fuck are you?
No, Monsieur le Président.
Don't point at me. Point at you.
Worth losing my time.
And why is that?
A second of my work is more important than the lifetime of each and every one of those plebeians. Besides, if I had reported it, I would have done them a favor.
What do you mean, Monsieur?
In jail,
what
they would
you
have
mean?
Had better living conditions than those
Judge will remember it.
Houses.
I understand. Please return to
now. Fuck off. Let me relive my past, and we're going to enter back. Oh, we can't. Shit. Alright, can we enter here? Rue de la Meconne? Enter building? Let's look at this nice looking penis shaped car.
Later, I wanted to start the car and go for a ride, but it ran out of fuel.
It ran out
from
of fuel.
Garnier, I al- For a
what
moment,
the hell is that?
I admired the charms of Montmartre.
I mean, this game is really beautiful at the moment. Alright, is this where we murdered her? I don't know. I want to check that place over there. But I'm scared that it's going to throw me in a jail.
I admired the charming streets.
I admired the streets of whatever again. You know, because I got beaten the shit out of by some weird men. Okay, we're gonna over here. So, ooh, this looks so nice, so fancy.
I entered the nearby
hotel. Oh no!
Caucasus.
No! Fuck. Remember that in order to arrange a credible line of defense, you will have to take time lapse into account. Press T to take access of the watch. Match your own actions with evidence, press tab, and the string of events according to prosecution, press Q. That's a lot of fucking information, man. T? So it seemed like she got murdered at like 11:15. So what's Q saying? The Q's rented a room on his name at the Cosmos Hotel, which is adjacent to the building in which he lives. It was in that room that approximately at 11:16 p.m. Marie Carpet was murdered. Supporting evidence, clerk's testimony 1, and guest book. Okay. What's tab? The murder weapon designed and manufactured by A. Ethan, so unique, found in the secret workshop of the accused. Unwashed traces of blood were found on it, as well as Ethan's fingerprints. Oh my god. So this game is kind of like you have to waste a lot of time and hide your shit. Is that right? I opened the inner door of the thing. I went shopping. Oh, come on! La frette! Poisson! Pomme! Tomate! Fromage! Ah, oh, let's get some fucking fromage! Oh, yeah. Oh, go down, you bitch. No! Oh, there we go. Fromage.
I bought a few things from my vending machine.
Since when does cheese come out of frickin' vending machine, man? Alright, let's get some pichon. Let's get some fish.
Then I bought something from the vending machine.
Let's see if he says it again. Let's get some gammon. Gambon. Jambon, is it?
I bought a few things from my vending machine.
Fine, Jesus. You're not going to say anything else? All right, what's this? And then I went to this room and looked at all these pieces of paper and rearranged them to fit my personal agenda with papers. All right, ooh. Make a call. Let's make a call. Come on, make a call.
I spent a few minutes talking on the phone.
Can I do that again?
I looked at posters promoting Paris.
Come on, man.
Later, I looked at posters advertising the attractions of Paris.
Right. Wait, how do I check the time again? Is it Y? Okay, this one's that. Okay, which one's the...
Later, I glanced into the phone room through one of the inner...
No. How do I check the time again? Fuck, I forgot. Is it B? Okay, B. Alright, it's 9:30. Alright.
I tried to open the door to the restaurant.
This
was closed because of the late hour. Later, I opened the door and walked out into the street.
I have fucking no idea what I'm doing, man. All right, let's check that thing that we wanted to check.
Then I opened the gate.
And then I opened the gate. And then I wanted to kill myself.
I do not recall that part.
What the fuck? How do you not recall that part? This is your life story, man. You just gotta lie. So am I beaten like this all the time? Oh, I can go back in. Alright, let's go to the Rue de la Verbeau.
I opened the door and entered the building where my apartment is.
What? I thought you were at the hotel. Fuck. Alright, let's check our apartment.
I opened the inner door.
I don't want... I'm going up the stairs.
Then I used the stairs.
I knocked on someone's door.
But no one answered.
Okay. I knocked again.
I knocked at Monsieur Brissot's door, and he called back after some time.
Do you always visit your neighbors at such
odd.
Oh yes,
hours.
We are great
Monsieur
friends.
Brissot is the only neighbor I like. I believe with reciprocity.
Reciprocity.
He goes to sleep late, and sometimes we like to argue about politics and the influence.
This game's so good. It's so in depth as well. I like just how we're pissing off the judge. It's so good. Oh, I went to his house. Shit. We made passionate love. He can say, ooh, whoa, look at this place.
I opened the door to the living room.
Oh, look at his house. Oh my God. Read and take the letter.
There was a letter tucked into Monsieur Brissot's book. The Lordship Service Association was the sender.
Why would I steal his letter? Oh my God, I got achievement. Defense evidence number
Monsieur
10.
President, this is the evidence marked with number 10.
The
it
fuck?
Is a letter
Let me go back.
A fictitious organization to Monsieur Brissot, which, as it was said in the letter, cultivated traditions of
what
the
French
fuck's
nobility going on?
And was sending
I don't
want to
be back in this shithole.
For free.
I'm an innocent man. You guys got to believe me before your fendora is on.
So the question arises, who had really sent Marie Capet to Monsieur Brissot? And what were their intentions?
Oh my God, am I manipulating evidence?
Thank you for the clarification. The accused may continue to testify.
Oh my God, we're so good. If you are covered in blood, you can wash it off by taking a bath or changing your clothes. If you are drunk, it will pass... I can't even say that word, I'm so tired. Wine? Okay, we don't want to drink. We want to,
I looked through Monsieur Brissot's heirlooms.
Is this a heirloom? Whoa, you look fabulous. This looks so real. Jesus. Alright, let's check the time. What's the time? Okay. We need to waste more time, I think. Hello, sir. Ooh, we can talk to Monsieur Brissot for 10 minutes. Alright, let's talk to him for 10 minutes.
For a good 10 minutes, I talked to Monsieur Brissot. And again, we had an argument about la révolution.
La révolution.
I felt regret that in modern France, the high birth was no longer relevant.
Oh my God, this is so fabulous.
Also, he boasted that he had hired a maid.
He looks a bit like,
found the money for her salary.
Like an older...
any effects of her work.
Why is he brown?
The apartment was a mess.
Bitch, go away!
Wasn't that
Stop pointing at me!
Thing?
That's rude! Didn't your mother tell you
Monsieur
pointing
Monsieur
is rude?
If someone hires a servant, one can expect order. And in this apartment, there was none.
I really need a
Did
bath or
something.
This blood's pissing me off.
Yes, I was going to say it. It turned out that it was Marie Capet, my old classmate. We grew up in the same city, and
right.
I had not known that she had moved to Paris.
So you admit... that you knew.
No, I don't.
Oui, I knew who she was.
Eh oui. Okay, we talked to this clown. Look at his apartment, it's so nice. All right, let's open the door.
I was curious to see behind the door in the living room, but I didn't want to upset my neighbor with my nosiness.
So you just like go through
the living room of Monsieur Brissot. I was curious to see behind the door, but I was curious to see behind the door, but did not want to.
Shit. Bitch, come on, let me in. Why can I not go here? It seems likely I can. Maybe she doesn't like the blood? Oh, come on. I can see her in the mirror. I mean, for the glass. It's not. Oh, fuck you. I'm going.
Then I opened the door and left the apartment.
Okay. Yeah, we need to somehow take a bath or change our clothes. All right, up we go. We must live on the top floor. All main characters are on
the
top floor.
I decided to use the stairs instead of the elevator.
God damn it. Damn it, frickin'.
I knocked, but no one answered.
Okay, this is our house. All right, let's enter your apartment.
I opened the door to my apartment and entered.
Why would we have an apartment, but then have a hotel room? Like, right down the street. Like, right opposite. Whoa!
I watched the frames hanging on the wall. I loved their simplicity.
Okay, we need a bath. Look at this shit! Look how fancy this fucking place is, man. Take a bath. Perfect. At least we can see shit properly now. I took a bath. Oh, an important event is approaching. Right bumper to acquaint with it. Hello? What the fuck? Someone's at my door. Get out! You better not be my neighbor. Fuck.
I heard someone knocking at
the door. Oh!
I opened it.
What?
And there she was, Marie Capet.
Make the woman leave and close the door. Oh, shit. Alright.
I invited Marie Capet inside. She said she remembered me from school and was curious how things.
Is she missing
done.
A hand? I think she's missing a hand.
She had been recently hired as a maid by my neighbor, Monsieur Brissot.
Right.
I showed her my apartment, my designs.
Oh
and
my
inventions.
God, look how beautiful this apartment is, man.
So
this is like the dream.
Interested in my interrogation machine. I took her to my private workshop.
Okay. Is she missing a hand? Pick up your journal and kill her. Why would you have that in your room? Okay, say goodbye.
I said goodbye to Madame Capet and closed the door.
Monsieur
fucking
Eaton,
judge again.
Why
stop pointing.
Did you make Madame Capet leave your
because she's a stingy
I
bitch.
I had a lot of work, Monsieur le Président, and I try not to invite single women to my apartment. I have to take care of my reputation.
Exactly.
I understand.
We have
please
reputation,
continue.
Man. You don't want some crazy women like going in our apartment, stealing our, you know, stealing our good craftsman work. You know, I like, you know, she doesn't realize I'm a vampire, you know? It's a hard life being a detective, vampire, murderer, scum. I'm trying to get away with it. Let's play piano.
I tried to play something on the piano. I must add that I cannot play, and the piano is just for decoration.
What the hell? Who does that? I wouldn't do that. Even if I had all the money in the world, I wouldn't just have, like, a freaking piano. You know, I would have something cool that I could do with. Like a cinema? Okay, what time is it? It's 10 o'clock. All right. We've got time.
I opened the inner door.
All right, shit. Eat leftovers? But that doesn't add time, does
I
it?
Ate
oh,
leftovers
God.
From my lunch and drank some wine.
Oh, no. Put the groceries in the cabinet.
I put my groceries into the cabinet in the kitchen.
Let's cook. Why not?
I took to cooking dinner.
I ate my leftovers, put the groceries away, and then I freaking start
I
cooking again.
Out of the window at the magnificent
oh my God, I'm so drunk. I can see four Eiffel Towers. I then went back to eating my leftovers.
I ate the leftovers from my lunch and drank some wine.
And then I put my groceries away. Oh, I can't. And then I started cooking again.
I was cooking dinner. For the next day.
And then I opened the door.
Opened the door.
And then I started to pass out. Oh my God. I then went upstairs.
Then I used the stairs.
I then I drew some art.
I glanced on the frames hanging on the wall.
There was nothing
Their
on it.
Simplicity calmed me down and allowed me to focus.
Oh my God, my bedroom. Okay. And then
I checked the elements of my cleaning machine.
Oh, it's a cleaning machine. Oh, let's work on our invention. 30 minutes. Let's waste time.
I worked on my new invention for about half an hour.
Can we have a smoke? No, we can make a call. We don't want to make a lot of calls, do we? It's going to be suspicious that we're wasting time, right? Music? Turn on the music.
I listen to music on the gramophone.
The gramophone. Okay, what time is it? Alright, she's dead in like a few minutes. I mean like 25 minutes. Alright, what's this? Open hidden door? Oh my God! Wait, what's this? Go to sleep 10 plus hours. End of your testimony. Alright, let's open this hidden door first.
I opened a hidden door behind my bookcase. Leading
oh
to my second workshop.
Oh, my second workshop.
Can you explain to the court why You have a hidden workshop?
I work there on my secret projects that I create independently of Le Feu.
Le Feu.
I understand. Please continue.
Now, F off. Wait, what? Wait, she was in here. Why was she in here?
I checked if the designs of my most important invention were still in place.
Please tell the court which invention these designs
are.
He's going to
point at me again.
To.
Oh, he's pointing at that thing.
It is classified information, Monsieur President.
That's hilarious.
Good. Please continue.
Please continue. Okay. Watch this. Pick up journal.
My journal, in which I describe the construction process.
You took a massive deuce.
Machine,
you couldn't handle the pressure. A what? Oh, evidence number 3. Yeah. Okay.
Monsieur le Président, this is the evidence marked with number 3. It clearly shows
we'll check out what else is in
his
room,
his
and then we'll sleep and see
the
what the outcome is, and then we'll end the video. So far, I'm liking it. It's like, it's really weird. It's not like weird as in the game's weird. It's weird because I've never played this style of game before, and it's really interesting.
In order to
it's like a walking simulator, but it like kind of reads...
My client
it's kind of like the Truman Show a little bit, but
the
without
the... The machine
this
would be
is,
conducted
this
under
is what he's done.
This
is what he's doing now and all that
kind
of cool
justice.
Stuff. I
Thank
like
you,
it.
Counselor. The accused may return to his testimony.
Okay, sweet. Let's pretend we're... Turn on
I
machines.
I turned down my prototype machine to interrogate prisoners.
Yeah, that's a very terrifying machine. All right. Ooh, book. We can read a book. Wait, what time is it? Alright, let's read a book. 15 minutes.
I read for a while the history of torture.
Are you interested in this subject?
It is not about hurting someone.
This?
But to use...
Are you gonna point at me? You gonna point at the book?
To
torture!
Do you think it is acceptable to inflict pain during the...
Yeah, you wanna have to take a seat, Judge?
In extreme cases, yes. But my device is not inflicting it. And the prosecutor, naming my device the torture machine, only shows his deep ignorance on that subject.
That's true.
Order, please. And I admonish the accused to make no offense to any of the participants of this trial. Please, return to your testimony.
I will. Just go away, man. Okay, what time is it? Oh, shit. It's 11 o'clock. All right. I'm not sure what else I can do. I'm kind of scared. Do I just go to bed?
I opened a hidden door behind my bookcase, leading to my second workshop.
Okay. And then we go to bed.
I was tired after the banquet, so I immediately went to sleep. I was even too tired to undress.
Is it all you want to testify, Monsieur Eaton?
Oui, Monsieur le Président.
So he's pointing at me in my bed.
It is time to present.
You get out of my bedroom! Creep! I'm trying to sleep! Oh, that's hilarious. It's funny. I don't know what the... I'm going to jail, obviously.
Monsieur le Président, the accused tried to trick himself off the responsibility. He used cunning rhetoric.
What?
Trying to hide more and more of his new lies. However, in view of the evidence presented by the prosecutor, I have no doubt that Alfred Eaton... Defendant who appeared today before the court murdered
what?
Marie Capet
no!
in cold blood.
You're wrong, monsieur.
Please, let the High Court not be deceived by his tearful stories about a poor gypsy from
I got beaten up on the street.
His success
oh, we failed, guys.
And which Marie Capet so cleverly tried to destroy. It was the accused who destroyed the life of a poor girl and her family with full premeditation.
Oh, this is so hard.
And what did that poor girl do to deserve
she died
such
it.
Cruel fate? She was searching for a better life.
Oh,
and
no.
was employed as a maid in the same building in which a dangerous psychopath... According to the prosecution, the accused
oh,
is
no.
guilty, Monsieur le Président.
No!
Therefore,
Mr. President, you were there! You know I wasn't
Alfred
guilty!
Eaton,
I'm innocent!
Today before the court, guilty of all charges
no,
against him.
No! Please!
Imposition of the death penalty
by beheading.
Oh no,
the
I need my head.
Thank you.
It's my thinking cap.
Monsieur le Président, Monsieur Prosecutor used a lot of high-flown words. However,
of course I used high-flown words. I'm a smart man.
He made many mistakes.
What?
As to the hotel room, my client had never rented a room
exactly.
in the Caucasus Hotel. The guest book was falsified.
Yes.
And the clerk made a false statement.
Yes.
As to the alleged attempt to use the torture device on the victim,
I didn't.
My client did not intend to use his interrogation device.
Oh my God, yes. This guy's winning it for us, man.
Torture machine.
Yeah.
Neither on Marie Capet nor on anyone else.
Oh my God. Oh,
the journal
so of
Alfred
weird.
Eaton clearly proves it, where he writes that he does not intend to use his device against honest, innocent people.
Exactly.
It is important to emphasize the relationship of Marie Capet and my client.
Oh my God. According Things are shaping up, guys. This is so intense.
A deep resentment and contempt, both for my customer and for his work.
Oh my
and
God.
Success.
I don't know the outcome of this, man. I feel I'm going to die.
Marie Capet in his apartment.
Off with your
Indeed,
head.
Marie Capet came to visit my client in his apartment. However, he did not let her in. We do not know where Madame Capet's fingerprints from inside of that apartment came
from.
She
didn't touch shit.
As for Alfred Eaton's weapon, please note, Monsieur le Président, that my client testified that he had not had the murder weapon on himself. The
I
knife
did.
Was in his secret workshop all that time.
I didn't even see the freaking
Everyone
weapon,
could
man.
Have stolen it and then dropped it off.
Exactly.
As for the murder, as my client testified, he did not kill Marie Capet.
Ooh,
so
shit.
Who did?
Who
as it
did?
Clearly appears from the letter to Monsieur Brissot, the maid, Marie Capet, was sent shortly before the murder.
Oh!
I have to add that the letter was sent from a non-existent organization.
Oh my God, this is so juicy.
And remuneration for
Holy
Marie Capet's
shit.
Work was not provided. So who and why had
Oh my God, thank God we didn't
as
go
for the testimony
to our freaking hotel room.
Who saw
Jesus.
Alfred Eaton entering the building covered in blood. According to my client's testimony, that meeting had never taken place.
Oh my God.
So the witness made a false testimony. Taking into account the evidence from the neighbor's
I can't
opinion,
believe this is happening. I think we've just, like, won.
An aversion
I think.
My client and racial prejudice.
Oh my God.
Thank you, Monsieur le Président.
In the game, you can find interactions. Okay, yeah. It means that using this object will skip time by the indicated number of minutes. It is useful when you are waiting for an important event. Oh shit, am I in jail? What? I thought I got out! Turn on water? I don't want to turn on water. Read a letter from Hugo. Hugo?
Mon cheri,
ami.
That you had to stand before the court, accused of such a terrible deed.
Oh my God.
I assure you that I deeply believe in your innocence, and will do my best, so that you can continue to work for the glory of Le Feu. And
so, am I innocent or not?
Cordialement, Hugo Argent.
Okay.
You gypsy scum.
You gypsy scum.
You can be sure that you will take responsibility
Fuck
for
you.
What you have done.
Fuck you. And kill her. You read my testimony.
And even neither your millions nor your connections will be able to help you. Is the stolen money not enough?
What stolen money?
To all these poor people not enough?
Oh, go away, you asshole.
Tear everything away from us.
Who's this bastard writing to me in prison?
Death to the rich.
Death to the rich.
Vive la nouvelle révolution.
Vive la livre révolution. Read an anonymous letter.
The French Gypsy Association wishes to send you support
yes.
and condolences for the
oh,
persecution
yes. oh my
caused
God.
By your gypsy origin.
Oh.
We are aware that it was the main...
Long live the gypsies, man. Help me out. Help me
we
bust out of this jail.
Haven if you decide to leave the prison in less official way. One of our persecuted members, who had also been imprisoned in
what?
The prison...
What? I can escape?
The mentions fuck? The decayed walls in most of
I
the
can
cells.
See, I can see the Eiffel Tower from here.
Maybe you could use this information.
Signed X.
What the hell is going on? This is so weird. Can I read a book? What? I can escape? What do I do? Oh shit, this letter's here.
Sheffield. Your father and I are quite sure that you did not do it.
Exactly. No, you quite? You gotta be 100% sure I didn't do this, man.
And we are waiting.
Believe in your son. I didn't do shit.
Please leave this cursed Paris and return to your home parts.
Mama et papa. Mama
et papa.
Et papa.
P.S.
P.S.
Papa asks you not to mention the hotel guest book. Apparently you know what that means.
What?
Sheffield, your father and I are praying for you, and we believe that the court will be merciful. Maman et papa. Postscriptum. Papa is sorry that it did not work as he had planned.
Shit. Let me out. What do I do? Oh my god. What? Do I just sleep and just die? I don't know what I'm meant to do. Do I have a clock still? No, it took my clock! Bastards! Oh my god. Alright, let's see what happens when I go to bed. I don't see- Oh my- What is happening? This game is hard. Alright, let's go to bed. The verdict- Is there gonna be like a verdict or something?
Monsieur Eaton, please hurry. The court is ready to announce the
verdict. Okay, here's the verdict. Shit.
The verdict on behalf of the République Française. The court, as present, hereby finds that Alfred Eaton, accused of murdering Marie Capet, is guilty of charges against him.
What?
And sentences the accused to the death penalty by beheading on the guillotine.
What the fuck?
The executions will be done in Prison de la Santé.
No! My lawyer is just saying that like, fuck. Oh my god. Oh my god, this is hilarious. Okay, summary. Unlocked evidence of defense, 2 out of 13. Judges confidence gain 0. Obvious lies uncovered by the court, 4. Discovered game ending, 7 out of 8. Justification of the verdict. There is no doubt that Alfred Eflin is guilty of the murder of Marie Capet. The court found no circumstances in favor of accused. Therefore, the most severe punishment was imposed. I got achievement death. Fantastic. Oh, no! Guys! You could have just cleaned the freaking table first. Why is there blood at the freaking end of the- No, please. Oh no. Ah. Oh my god. You were sentenced to death. Unlocked endings 1 out of 9. Prepare a new line of defense. Try again and discover other endings. And A. Ethan beheaded on La Guillotine. That's epic. Holy shit. Finn. Oh my god. Free complete guide? Holy shit. Oh my. I really enjoyed that. Holy crap. Thanks, Moon. What is it? Moonwalls games? Or Moonwalls? That was fantastic. It was really good. You can purchase this game on Steam for like 10 quid. It's got like multiple endings and a. You know, it's really good for, like, its price, actually. Like, most games nowadays, like, you pay, like, almost 20 quid for, like, a early access, and it's not that in-depth as this game. I know this game came out, like, in 2016, but they must have, like, updated it or something, and they sent me a free key, so I'm really appreciative on that, and I really had fun. It's so different from, like, other games that I've played, so this kind of detective-style, free-roaming adventure and, like, trying to like lie your way out of it is brilliant. It's absolutely brilliant. More games should be like this in depth. Oh my god. A few things though, like maybe the subtitles could be of like, you could change the size. It was a bit small like for my screen. I don't know. don't know. It seemed pretty good for like what it's worth, and it's quite in depth actually. I didn't expect it to be that in depth, but I really enjoyed it. I hope you guys did too. If you could leave a like on the video and support Moonwalls, I keep forgetting them. Sorry, the Moonwalls. That would be perfect. I will put in the description where you can buy this game if you are interested in it, or you can actually go to key mailers and probably ask them if they, you know, for a key. I'm not sure if you'll get that, but I do have another game to play. I'll make a video on that probably tomorrow. I've made two videos today, and this one's quite a bit longer because I wanted to know the ending. I didn't want to just like rush through it, and it was quite difficult actually. You gotta like find like 13 evidences and try to persuade them that you didn't do it. And I thought we kind of manipulated the evidence in our way, but nope. We still bit the big one and we got guillotined to death, which is hilarious. But anyway, guys, I hope you liked it. And I'll catch you guys in the next video. Goodbye.